Hello, 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 mis amores. How are you doing? I'm so happy that you're here. So today we're gonna be making not one, not two, but three of my go-to dinner recipes for the week. First up, we're gonna be making a Chipotle style bowl, but best believe it's gonna be much more flavor. Number two, we're gonna be making some curry. I'm gonna show you all how I take a jar of curry and infuse it with some more love, some more flavor. All the flavor of curry, half of the work. It's delicious, I promise you. And last but not least, we're gonna be making a quick lasagna. This will be a vegetarian style lasagna. We're gonna be using some Trader Joe's. This video is not sponsored by Trader Joe's, but they use a lot of their products. With some Trader Joe's soy chorizo. It's so good, so flavorful. I cannot wait to share these recipes with you. Stick with me and I will share with you how I make them. The timestamps for each one of these recipes will be in the description box below. Enjoy. Alrighty, my loves, let's get it going with the deliciousness. So in my pot, I'm starting with my rice of choice, which is jasmine rice for me. And I've got some olive oil, some salt. For every 1 cup of rice that I make, I use 1.5 cups of water. And that I find is perfect for me and my jasmine rice. So here I've got 1 pound of boneless, skinless chicken thighs that I season with 1 teaspoon each of oregano, cumin, and garlic powder. And I chopped it up into bite-sized pieces and I let it saute in my pan with a little bit of oil for about 3-4 minutes aside. Flipped it over, did it 3-4 minutes on the other side until it was nice, a little bit charred, delicious, little golden brown. Mm. This is some flavorful chicken right here, I promise you. And I also put some salt in there, of course, with the chicken. So salt to taste there. So here go my rice. Once the water came down to the rice, I turned it down to low and just let it go undisturbed for about 15 minutes until it was nice and fluffy. But you'll see that in a minute. So here I go with making the fajitas, right? So I chopped up about one onion total and 1 small orange bell pepper. And now off to the side, you see the tomatoes. I'm making the pico de gallo, the mild salsa. So I have 2 Roma tomatoes that I added about 1 tablespoon of finely diced red onion to. Then we're gonna go ahead and move on to the guac. Look at this beautiful avocado, y'all. That's just the best feeling in the world. You know what I mean? It's just simple pleasures. So I'm going ahead and scoring my avocado, putting it into the bowl. And for all 3 of my side dishes here that you see I'm making, I put the same exact ingredients pretty much in each one. So I put a little bit of red onion in the guac. I put a little bit of cilantro in the guac. And I did the same thing for the tomatoes. I like doing it like this because it just helps it to be a little bit easier so I don't have to go back and forth between each dish. You know what I mean? So in each one of these bowls, I added in the juice of 1/2 of a lime. All right, so I did that as well with my cabbage mixture. I like a cabbage mixture instead of salad. I feel like salad is boring, but I like using this. This is just coleslaw from the bag, right? You get in the produce section that I'm jazzing up. I find this is much more interesting and flavorful than just throwing some lettuce on top. So always season my loves at every single step. This is where you're gonna get that flavor, all right? So I'm going in with garlic powder and salt in each one of these. You don't wanna just season the guac, but not the tomatoes or the salad, because then those two are gonna be lack of flavor, you know what I mean? So season at every single step that you can. Here I go with some olive oil, just a little splish there. In both of those salads. All right, so here we go. We're gonna about to get ready to fry the fajitas. I put in a little swizzle of olive oil. I got it on a medium high heat. Then I'm gonna add in my red and white onion. I ran out of white onion, that's why you see me using some red there. And then the bell pepper. I let this go for just less than 3 minutes. I didn't want it to be soggy. I wanted the veggies to have a little bit of crunch. So I let it go on there, add a little bit of salt, a little bit of garlic powder. Yes, season at every step. I promise it makes a difference. And we're gonna let that go and we'll toss that to the side. And in the same pan,
I'm gonna go ahead and make our corn. Yes, my stove is messy. My stove is messy. When I'm making a bunch of different components of my meal like this, it gets messy, but life is messy. Cooking is messy. You know what I mean? All right. So with the corn, I had some corn in my freezer. I added in a half teaspoon of garlic powder, of cumin, coriander, and a quarter teaspoon of red chili powder, and a little quarter teaspoon here of oregano. And I added in some red onion to that as well, and of course some salt. I'm gonna let this kind of fry on medium high heat for, again, about 4 minutes. It does not take long at all, but I like to let it go a little longer so it gets that charring that you can see here that you would find at Chipotle. You get a lot of flavor in this. This is like one of my favorite sides. There it goes there. You got a little bit of charring on there. If you want to be a little fancy, throw some cilantro in there. And here goes all of the sides. This is just such a flavorful Chipotle bowl. So I also added cilantro and lime juice to the rice. The beans that you see here are actually from my mama. My mumsy made these beans for me and I had them in the freezer. But fear not, I have a quick and easy black bean recipe for you that I will put in the iCards. The yogurt sauce that I'm using, the Raita, I have a video for that too. That will be in the description box. Or you could just use sour cream, and there goes the bowl. We're moving right along to the curry. This curry, according to my boyfriend Nuhubi, was delicious. We are jazzing up a bottle of Trader Joe's curry. All right, here goes the jar right here. And when you're using any jar, whether that goes curry or if it's a red sauce like a marinara, you always want to taste for salt first. Okay, so here you see my chicken. I got another pound of chicken that I cleaned, cut up into bite-sized pieces, added in a teaspoon of garlic powder, some salt, and half of a lime. All right, I just set that aside while I'm getting everything else ready. So here I have got about a half of a white onion that I am kind of letting go just to get soft for a little bit. Does not take too long. Then I went in with my cloves of garlic and my little knob of ginger that I chopped, adding in a bay leaf and a small little thing of cinnamon stick. If you don't have these ingredients, that's okay. Just try and get as close as you can, or use the spices that you have, all right? You can't go wrong here. So here I go in with a quarter teaspoon each of turmeric and red chili powder. Then I had a half a teaspoon each of coriander, dried coriander, and cumin. I'm gonna let those spices bloom. This is on a lower heat, right? So I added in a little bit of water to this so that my spices can bloom. You don't want your pan, when you're blooming your spices, to be too high. That's how they burn and you end up with a bitter taste, all right? So make sure that your heat is on the lower side, all right? So I went in with half my bottle of my Trader Joe's curry sauce. You can use any brand of curry sauce that you like. Then I went in with the chicken that I had marinating for that 20 minutes or so. I did not add any salt to my dish, y'all, because my bottle of curry, remember I tasted it first, had enough salt. So I did not add any salt. The only salt was the chicken. Here I go with some plain yogurt to add a little bit of tang, a little bit of creaminess. And then I let it just simmer away just like that for about 20 minutes until the chicken was cooked. And bingy, bingy, bam. Whatever. I don't know what I just said. Bingy, whatever. Bing, bang, boom. It was all done. I added in some coconut milk as well to give it a little bit more richness, a little bit more creaminess. I really enjoy it like that. And that was it. I served up my curry. This curry was banging. It was delicious. Please tell me if you try this and let me know how it goes for you. All right. So here I served mine up with some porridge and my little roti there on the side. And that was it. So we're moving on to our meatless lasagna. I got one carrot, about half of a bell pepper, and some garlic that I'm gonna just soften. I ran out of onion by this point in the week, so I just kind of used what I had. If you don't have these, if you have any other aromatics that you want to use, add those in, okay? You can't go wrong. So here I am sauteing my carrots and red pepper, letting those get softened ahead of time, then adding the garlic. We do that so that we don't burn the garlic, right? You don't want to add the garlic in with the others and then it burns. You know how it goes. So I'm adding in a tablespoon of tomato paste. Then there goes my Trader Joe's soy chorizo. Yes, this is a non-meat soy chorizo. It was delicious, actually, in a lasagna. It's not spicy, but it has a lot of flavor to it. And it added a nice meatiness to the lasagna without adding any meat at all. So it was really good. So I went in with a little handful of dried oregano, a couple bay leaves. And here goes my store brand jarred tomato sauce. I added in a little bit of red chili powder for a little bit of spice. And then there I go with about a half of a cup of water, and I let that kind of bubble away on a low heat for just 10-15 minutes. Nothing does not take too long. It's everything's already cooked, all right? And the flavor, there's so much flavor there already. So for my ricotta, I used about a cup of ricotta cheese. I added in a little bit of freshly grated nutmeg to that, and then I added in some cilantro. I would have used parsley or basil, but I did not have that, so and I wanted something fresh, so that's what I use. Don't ask me about boiling no lasagna sheets. I do not like doing that. I generally get one of these pre-made sheets that you can just put into the oven. I got this at my grocery store. I went in with half of a cup of the meat mixture, the non-meat mixture. Then I went in with the lasagna sheet, the ricotta, the more meat mixture, cheese, and then rinse, repeat until you get to the top of your dish. Like so, and then top with plenty of mozzarella cheese. You're going to want to tent that bad boy so it doesn't get too brown. Just pop it into the oven for about 35-40 minutes, and this is what you end up with. It was so good. I served it with a little salad on the side, and it was such a quick and delicious week night dinner. Here it goes with the curry. I served that with the raita, the yogurt sauce. Don't forget a recipe for that in the description. And last but not least, the better than chipotle bowl. Y'all, I need you all to try these recipes out. Let me know how it goes for you. Which one was your favorite? I am so excited to hear back from you all. And please subscribe for more. And I will see you in the next one.